So I think it's like 9:52 right now, and I literally just got in a room. I literally have not been asleep, y'all. I'm like so tired, but I'm here and I am ready. So my appointment is literally like maybe 5 hours away. It's like at 4. So yeah, so y'all, so this is a room, this is a restroom, and this is the room. I don't know why it's not good lighting here, but it looks way better. And then this is the view. So yeah, it's actually really nice, really roomy. There go the color. There we go. And this is like the coolest part. You have to stick your little key in there, keep the lights on. And here's the restroom. Here's a better look. The restroom, shower, and yes, this is it. So I think it's like 9:52 right now. And I literally just got in a room. I literally have not been asleep, y'all. I'm like so tired. But I'm here and I am ready. So my appointment is literally like maybe 5 hours away. It's like at 4. So yeah, so I think I'm gonna try to get some rest. I really can't sleep, but I'm gonna try. But in the meantime, y'all, look what I did. My purse on. Hey, so cute. I got bored, so yeah, but so I'm gonna try to get some sleep and I will be back when it's time to go. So be back. We just got here, waiting to get inside. The weather is really bad, it's raining. I'm sitting in the parking garage, so stay tuned.
Hola, doña Vicky, estoy aquí abajo para que bajen por ella. Bueno,
a little park from the mall.
Nice, this looks like our mall.
Outside,
mm-hmm.
It's another park.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Here we are. We are
here.
Done. Thank you so much. I love my smile.
I love your new smile. Love. You look awesome. So gorgeous.
Thank you.
Yeah, I love.
Alrighty, that's it.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, guys. So I felt like I missed some very important things in this video, and that's why we're about to get into what I missed. And those things were, of course, what to expect when traveling to Colombia, the things that you need to pack. I did want to do a packaging video of me packaging everything that I included in my bags, but for some reason I got so busy I didn't get a chance to do that. So let's get into this. First things first, you do need your passport, so please ensure that you get your passport ahead of time. That's very important. That's just like the biggest thing that you need. You need your passport. You need your passport in order to do anything, wherever you do when traveling out of country. So, of course, we do need our passport. So, please make sure you order your passport in advance. You can get your passport at the United States Postal Service and order it there. So, okay, so once you have your passport, then you want to ensure that you get your COVID-19 test. Nowadays, you do need your COVID-19 test in order to travel to country. So make sure that you get your COVID-19 test. But look, it has to be the PCR COVID-19 test. You cannot travel out of country without your PCR. Not the quick rapid test, but the PCR. You will be stopped and turned around. You also need to fill out your migration form online. The government there ensure that everyone has it. They will not let you over country without that either. So okay, we got that out the way. We know we need that to travel. Now let's get into what we need to pack into our bags. So the number one things that I had to pack in my bag that I felt that was important to me was, of course, my hygiene. Travel size hygiene. Do not bring anything excessive or big. For me, I only stayed there one day, so all I needed was basically my small toiletries or whatever like that. One outfit for me. Of course, I pack things that would keep me occupied because of the travel. I brought my planner, I brought my laptop, and I brought my book. Make sure you have all your chargers and everything like that. And that pretty much was it. That's all I packed in my bag. Don't forget your mask, your gloves, your sanitizer, your wipes. That's all the stuff that I packed. Then after that, we're gonna get into who did I fly with. I flew Delta. Delta was absolutely wonderful. I flew Delta there and United back. The flight is approximately 6 hours away. So 6 hours going, 6 hours coming back. I had a layover in Bogota, Colombia. I'm not sure if everyone have a layover in Bogota, Colombia, but for the most part, that's what it looks like to me. That once you fly, you will land in Bogota, Colombia, which is the capital. You will land there, then you will fly from Bogota to Cali, Colombia for your procedure. Bogota Airport was absolutely wonderful. Even though I landed that night, I didn't really get the experience that night, but trust me, that next morning when I got there, absolutely beautiful. The mall there is beautiful inside the airport. Of course, I went shopping. I got a little few things or whatever. And so the airport in Bogota is absolutely beautiful. The airport in Cali is very small, but y'all, I'm telling you, when you get to Cali, Cali is so beautiful. Like, Cali is beautiful. I love Cali. The people there are wonderful. I didn't kind of get a bad experience with the people. The only thing I did have a bad experience with was TSA. I had a little experience with them. I just felt like they were treating me different a little bit because of my nationality or whatever. But for the most part, everything else, everyone was beautiful. Once you land into Cali, Colombia, the driver with the dentist office will be there to pick you up. He will have a sign waiting for you with your name on it that says the company of the dentist office, and he'll have your name there. He'll be waiting for you. He was absolutely nice. He spoke to me. They do contact you days before on WhatsApp and say, hello, this is the driver. This is who I am. This is the kind of car that I'll be driving. Here's my license plate, and here's a picture of me. So I absolutely love that part. The dentist office will also be keeping in contact with you as well to ensure that you land there safe, let you know that your driver is there to pick you up and to get you to your hotel. So, the hotel that I stayed at was the Intercontinental Hotel in Cali, Colombia. It was absolutely beautiful. This was, to me, a 5-star hotel in their country. That was a good part. That was a plus. I do include the video for that in this in this as well. And then what else do we have to go over? The next day they will be there to pick you up or whatever. And yeah, so that's pretty much it, you guys. It's not really much to it. The dentist's office was absolutely wonderful. The visit was wonderful. Just know that there's a difference between porcelain and raisin veneers. That's very important. And there's also a price difference. The price difference depends on your teeth, so I cannot give you an absolute price on how much your cost will be. But my cost was $6,000. That's not including the flight. You do not have to pay for your hotel. It's just the flight that you need to insure. Alrighty? Alright, you guys. That's it.